So it's been a few days. You see, one of the great things about living on your own is that you can eat cold pizza, you can store things in your refrigerator, and you don't have to worry about other people eating them. So, in my old house, right, every time my mom would buy a packet of Oreos or Pop-Tarts, it would literally be a food competition all the time, 24/7, because my brother at the time loved Pop-Tarts. I loved Pop-Tarts. My mom liked Pop-Tarts. My dad liked Pop-Tarts. And it got to the point where everyone in our family, when my mom would buy food like Oreos or Pop-Tarts, we would actually hide the Pop-Tarts, at least me. I would hide the Pop-Tarts around the house so they couldn't find them, so I could have more of them for myself, because who the fuck does not like Pop-Tarts? In any case, guys, I'm in my new place, as you can see, and I am very, very kind of echoey, because I don't have everything in here. I have most of it. I'm going to pick up the rest of my dresser and a few other things and clothes today. Who is Skyping me right now? Okay, sorry about that. In any case, I want to talk about, this is actually a personal video. Yes, I'm eating pizza. Let me put this down. So, I'm in my own place. I'm on my own now. I'm away from my household that I used to live in, which was a religious household. I just want to give you a little feedback, or I'd like to give you a little background as to why I moved out. More specifically, it actually had to do with religion. I love my mom and dad very much, but there was some things happening in our household which my dad eventually told me that I need to get ready and leave because he can no longer support, I guess you would say, how did he say this? He said it in a nice way, but I know what he was trying to say. Basically, my beliefs are interfering, my beliefs, as in I have a lot of beliefs, but my videos, he knows about my videos. I actually had to block my dad from YouTube over a year ago because he would watch some of my videos and he would get very upset over the content that I would make on the internet. And my dad's a very black and white person. He viewed him supporting what I have to say in my videos, which I don't believe is bad at all. I support gay marriage. My dad does not, if that gives you any type of perspective. And by using his internet, he was knowingly supporting the things that he does not support, such as gay marriage, and I talk about why gay marriage should be legalized, and he doesn't believe in that, so I'm using his internet that he's paying money for, so therefore, there was always this conflict. So I blocked him on YouTube so he couldn't see my videos, but even still, my dad and me clashed at everything. One of the hardest things for me growing up, and even this until I moved out recently, is that we would get in fights all of the time. Not like physical fights, but verbal fights where I'm sitting at the dinner table eating with my mom, who is very, very religious, and my dad, who is very, very religious. My dad is a black and white person. It's either this way or that way. There's no in between. There's no debate. He's my father. He's right. That's the way it's going to be. I hate that mentality, but that's my dad. And anything where my mom is very open-minded, she's a more flexible Christian, as I would like to say. So anytime my mom would talk to me or ask me, hey, Daniel, what do you make a video about? And I'd say, oh, I made a video about abortion and why I think abortion should be a woman's right to her own body. And then, of course, my dad would instantly jump in and say, oh, so-and-so, blah, 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 blah. No, I disagree with you. You're wrong. And of course, I don't like being told that I'm wrong simply because I believe in equal rights or that a woman should have a choice to have an abortion. So then we would start arguing. We've had arguments that stemmed from evolution, from him telling me that I have no morality because I am an atheist, because I am not a moral person, because I don't have God in my life, because I don't believe these certain things, that ultimately I'm a depraved human being, and I'm going to be more lonely. I'm never going to feel a sense of love if I'm not a Christian or that I don't have a relationship with God. That's the type of stuff that we would get into. So we'd clash all the time. And it got to the point where now my dad, about 6 months ago, said to me that I need to move out. And I was like, okay. Thankfully, I had money saved up to where I had money to where I can move into my place that I'm in right now and hopefully live here for the next year or so or longer. And eventually, I want to buy my own house, but that's in the long run, I have a lot of saving I have to do, and I have to really manage my money very carefully. But anyways, that's why, ladies and gentlemen, I had moved out, because my beliefs were interfering with my relationship with my father, and it was getting to the point of where he could no longer tolerate having me at the house. So I hope that makes sense, and I hope that clarifies some things. Also, I would like to mention really shortly is that my dad is not the same person that he used to be, because 2 years ago, he had a stroke, and that stroke, he woke up and he was blind. We took him to the hospital, they got him fixed up, but he had a mini stroke, which affected his brain. His second stroke, which happened less than a year ago, he nearly died, and if we hadn't got him to the hospital, he would have actually passed away in our garage, where I found him laying on the ground having a full-size stroke, which did permanent brain damage to him. And ever since that stroke, that second time stroke, my dad is not the same person. And it's very difficult for me, because growing up, I had a fairly good relationship with my father until this brain damage, this stroke. I don't know the medical jargon to describe the problem, but he's not the same dad that I used to have several years ago. And it's difficult for me because he argues with me on everything. We clash at everything, and it used to never be this way. But ever since the stroke, my dad's turned into a different person. And it's difficult for me to love and accept him as the person he used to be, knowing that he's not that same person now due to the stroke, and he just thinks completely differently. His beliefs are more radical, I would actually say, than he used to be. And it's just been very difficult to cope with, knowing that my dad is not the same person he was a couple years ago. So hopefully this makes any sense. Hopefully this is kind of more of a personal video talking to you guys about my personal life in regards to my family, something I don't really do very often. This is not going to be a super occurrence that happens on my channel. And anyway, guys, my name is Mr. Repsion, also known as Daniel Solzbach. I have several awesome religion videos in the works. I will also be making some relatively new cooking videos. Since I'm in my apartment, I'm going to teach you some basic cooking methods to survive on your own. So until then, see you next time. My name is Daniel Solzbach, also known as Mr. Repsion. Peace the rep out, and have a fantastic Thursday.